This is your boy, Mr. G. We're riding in the rain to the Wharton State Forest. And I want to real quickly talk about rites of passage. Rites of passage. How, you know, I don't know that there even are any rites of passage for teenagers anymore. When I was a kid, there still were. In the 70s and 80s, there still were. My students, I don't see it, not so much. They are pretty much just given everything. And there isn't really an earning scenario that goes on. But for us, there absolutely was. Playing in the rain, fools! Woohoo! And For my generation, your first car or motorcycle was 175% a rite of passage, especially for guys. So, I will tell you that meant that in the fall, you raked leaves to earn money towards that car or that motorcycle, or for me, it was actually a moped. That was really my own first dirt bike. I was just, you know, using mopeds and riding them through the woods. That meant in the winter that you shoveled snow. You see where I'm going with this? You didn't have to be old enough to get a job. You went out and you found something to do that would earn you some money. Nobody needed their driveway shoveled in our neighborhood, not with my family and, you know, five boys running around the neighborhood with shovels saying, $10 and we'll clean that driveway for you. And we would earn several hundred dollars on a snow day each. So, I mean, we were out there for 4, 5, 6 hours shoveling snow. Come in, have some hot chocolate, put on dry clothes, go back out. You know, in the spring, same kind of thing. Like, let's get ready to earn some money. What can we do? Well, you'd start getting all your lawn equipment together. My dad had a rule, our lawn first, and I'm allowed to use this equipment. So I would cut our lawn in the spring and in the summer, and then I was allowed to take that lawnmower, fill it with gas on my dad's dime, fill it with oil if it needed it on my dad's dime. As long as our lawn was cut, I was allowed to take it. And I would go start cutting the neighbor's lawns, $10-15 here or there. And on a Saturday, you know, tax-free, I'm pulling in $100-$120. We didn't need lawn companies to come do our lawns. The kids went out and cut lawns. You know, now, somebody will probably get taken to court because their kid operated the lawnmower and got hurt. I don't know. But that's how I grew up. You want something, you go get it. And what we wanted the most was our independence. And the way we got our independence was through getting our first vehicle, you know? And so you got to earn that vehicle. With my own children, I did not buy them a vehicle. I was willing to chip in if they showed that they were doing their part. And, you know, like with my son, he had to come up with at least half before I would even consider the discussion. So I'm just wondering, like, what was your rite of passage growing up? Was a vehicle part of your rite of passage? And if so, like, how did that go for you? Or was it something totally different? Let's do four-wheel drive here for a second. There we go. Let's do four-wheel drive. Woohoo! And with that, there's your boy, Mr. G, on Essential G. Drop me some comments in the comment section because I can't talk right now because I'm about to go in these woods and get all kinds of dirty with the JEEP. And let me know, what was it like for you? Like, share, and subscribe. Your boy, Mr. G, and I'm out. Peace.